And apparently, 10,000 plus wanted to talk about one sweatpants wearing colostomy bag having Al Thompson. Because
you see, I set it up perfect. Who knew except me that this was going to go down this way?
It did.
Welcome to the RX Power Hour, your home for news, information, and entertainment from the world of strength and power sports. And now your host, the man of the hour, the man with the power, Mike Johnston.
If you can count,
come on, Cyrus, we're with you.
Go ahead, bro.
Now look what we have here before us. We've got the Saracens sitting next to the Jones Street Boys. We've got the Moon Runners right by the Van Cortlandt Rangers. Nobody is wasting nobody. That is a miracle. And miracles is the way things ought to be. You're standing right now with 9 delegates from 100 gangs. And there's over 100 more. That's 20,000 hardcore members. 40,000 counting affiliates. And 20,000 more not organized, but ready to fight. 60,000 soldiers. Yeah. Now, there ain't but 20,000 police in the whole town. Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
Welcome, friends, to the RX Power Hour. It's been an eventful couple of weeks. Wow. There's so much going on. So much has gone on in the strongman world. The Arnold is coming up. The Loglift Championship has gone by. Interesting stuff to talk about there. Obviously, the Arnold. We'll have one more show before the Arnold. We'll kind of do our pre-Arnold, sort of breakdown. And of course, myself and my esteemed colleague, fellow strength monger, B.Chavez, will be on hand at the Arnold. we'll both be hanging around. But a question a couple of weeks ago, and actually errantly, my fault, I forgot to post it up on the RX Power Hour Facebook page, but the question of the week, the RX Power Hour question of the week was, what is it that you folks would like to talk about? Well, based on
a question that I got much maligned by my co-host, I might add. Let's not leave that out.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm trying to do right by the public, you know. Anyway, welcome, proceed, Chavez, my friend.
Welcome, Chavez.
Proceed.
And apparently, 10,000 plus wanted to talk about one sweatpants wearing colostomy bag having Al Thompson. Because
you see, I set it up perfect. Who knew except me that this was going to go down this way?
I'll tell you what. You are a soothsayer, my friend. You are like wow. You are like a swami. You got like a in your evil genius
among
closet,
many things, but yes, sir.
In your evil genius closet, you got one of like them turbans and a fucking crystal ball.
No, but I do hold the envelope to my forehead.
Karnak the Magnificent. You guys have to go way back to Johnny Carson before.
Way back, brother.
Before Jimmy Fallon. Anyway, the last time we were on, we were, I certainly, as always, was fucking ballyhooing the fact that the Giants Live is in your face and it's for the people and we won't be undersold, and by God, it's coming. And what do I know? I get a letter. The show, I don't even think it had actually come out yet, the Valentine's Day show. And I get a call Friday the 13th. Thursday, February 12th. And then, of course, Friday the 13th got the official letter from the Europa that they were folding, much like a house of cards, Chavez.
That is exactly the analogy you used when you called me in a froth.
Yeah, to the intimidation and pressure of one strongman hater, Al Thompson. Yeah.
I don't even know if it's strongman that the man hates, but he's definitely got some issues.
Yeah, he's definitely got some issues. But we posted some information. And honestly, we're not here really to demean Al Thompson. I think his actions, he demeans himself with what he's trying to do, because what he's really doing is taking away opportunity from strongman competitors. And he does it under the guise of, you know, the children, save the children from the evils of performance-enhancing drugs. He's basically like a guy that runs into a movie theater and yells fire. I could be mistaken.
You're much, much more versed on this, but I'm actually not aware of any children competing in Strongman at Large, America's Strongest Man, World's Strongest Man, Arnold Classic. None of that. Really? Was there any IFSA children? Has that really been an issue at any point?
Is it like ISIS? Do they have like the Strongman camps somewhere over in Eastern Europe? They have like Strongman camps. We got all these little strongmen doing mantras and they're like feeding them like little buckets of steroids and the little tiny strongmen.
I was thinking more like in like a Southeast Asian sweatshop, like North Korean kids like forced to move the same rock back and forth all day long. And
it's like,
I don't know.
It's like Conan. They have like a bunch of them turning this huge Conan's wheel, duh. And they just keep carrying it and carrying it and carrying it until they become big giant strongmen.
Sisyphean.
Right. That must be what Al's talking about.
Nonetheless,
Al had started a smear campaign, as a lot, most of you hopefully know by now. It's been well documented, and my duty as a promoter, unfortunately it affected myself and my constituency has been affected, but my peeps, anybody that took the time to sign up for this contest, anybody that had taken the time to train, prepare for this event, they were affected. The sponsors who paid money, they were affected. The Europa, even though they kind of caved, they were affected too, because his ramblings and his rantings caused them to have events pull out of the Europa Games. They had a youth wrestling group that pulled out because of Al's wild accusations. Now, this stuff goes back, Chavez, forever, this IMG stuff, and their IMG and CBS, they're all in cahoots to, you know, to sell performance-enhancing drugs. They're drug traffickers. You know, he calls out the Wessels crime syndicate. Al Thompson still believes that Willie and Deanne are married and that United States Strongman and NAS have separated only as a ruse to conceal their nefarious crime family. I mean, this guy, and this is not stuff I'm making up. This is stuff he posts all over the internet. Iron Mind, anywhere that'll listen to him, he posts this garbage on the internet. Well, at some point he got into the ear of a state senator in Pennsylvania. And they came up with this resolution, which is really nothing more than a bunch of state senators patting each other on the back and saying, this isn't good, and we have a resolution that says so. And it really isn't a law. It's nothing. It's a resolution. It's nothing. We don't like, you know, we don't like criminals. We don't like bad guys. We don't like, you know, cheese and crackers. It doesn't mean anything. But this so-called resolution 626, it actually goes a little bit further because it names certain organizations, but Chavez, you'll be
which I think, by the way, I think is a dangerous litigious slope to slide on, because some of those organizations have some moxie, and well, they may just turn around and kick these people in the dick.
Well, here's the thing, Chavez, you'll be happy to know that the people have spoken. Over 10,000 hits on this post on RX Power Hour Facebook page. And there are strongmen now that have reached out to MHP, because MHP has been a friend to Al Thompson in the past, and just said that they're going to stop carrying or taking MHP products if they continue to be involved with this guy. They are organizing. Ashley House Smith, God bless you, Ashley House Smith. She is writing senators in the state of Pennsylvania and in New Jersey, asking them where they got their facts. Because what it says in that resolution is that performance-enhancing drugs are rampant in sports. And it says, whereas, so like this is proof, because we are little state representatives and we say it, it must be true, whereas performance-enhancing drugs are running rampant in professional sports, and whereas the Arnold Classic, World's Strongest Man, and America's Strongest Man are the worst offenders. And Al points out, as he says, as you can see, three events were singled out as the worst offenders for allowing and encouraging steroid use. Allowing and encouraging. Where the fuck, what is this, the United States of America, Chavez?
Well, I'm not sure if it is, too, truthfully. That's a separate subject for a separate day.
Are we innocent until proven guilty?
Well, there's where I was going to go, is to make an accusation, you either need tangible proof of guilt, like people holding drugs in their fucking hands, or you need failed drug tests. And it just so happens that there really is no drug test. Therefore, there's no proof. Therefore, this is all utter and complete speculation.
Well, it's worse than that, because he's claiming trafficking, encouraging steroid use.
Well, that the encouraging part I was going to ignore, because that's just ludicrous. It's ludicrous in a way that's unimaginable, because you're talking about commercial enterprises. That's like saying bubblegum commercials are promoting pornography, because there might actually be some cleavage in the twins on the Double Mint commercial. So they're promoting pornography by selling bubblegum.
Well, that's true, because every time I chew gum, I get a Woody.
Well, and I do think the twins, but that's not the point.
You're right. But here's the good news. The strongman community is on this thing. Representative Hackett, 28 other sponsors that voted unanimously to pass this thing. And let me tell you what this is. Basically, it says steroids are bad. Kids doing steroids are bad. American strongman, we hate it. It says nothing. It barely mentions. There's like a couple lines where it mentions World's Strongest Man. It mentions, the Arnold Classic, and it mentions American Strongman. But it does it in such a way that there's no proof. It just merely mentions them. and the fact that, you know, setting fire to a building with people trapped inside, elderly people, you know, that can't get out of their chairs is not a good thing. You know, B.Chavez, evil genius sports performance, you know, Nazism. Put those things together and we can agree that that's not good. That's what they're doing. They're throwing shit at the wall to see what sticks. None of it's proven. None of it has any merit. In fact, it's just, and here's what I think happened. Joe Hackett's sitting in his office, right? Joe Hackett's secretary. And Al Thompson calls. I need to speak with Representative Hackett. He's busy right now. He'll call you back. 5 minutes later, Al Thompson. I need to speak with Senator Hackett. I need to speak with Senator Hackett or Congressman or local Representative Hackett. I need to speak with local Representative Hackett. And Al probably went about doing this for days, weeks, years, until this guy was like, fuck it, fine. Yes, kids, steroids, bad. Who did you say again? World's Strongest Man, American Strongman? Fine, I'll put it in there. That's what I can only imagine happened. They just caved to this guy's constant harping.
Most likely, that's how people like that succeed. And also, they throw in the children. Anybody will do anything for children. Oh, children God. Are our prized possession. And don't get me wrong, I have two children. I have three children. I have one adult child and two children. And they are my prized possession, and I would do anything for them. But that doesn't mean you can use them like the boogeyman. That anything that might in some way danger children is poison to all of society. Because that is fucking asinine. Pornography is probably not good for children. But you know what? I fucking love it. And it's shameful that people use children to prevent me from getting something I want. Well, and I'm sorry I'm yelling at you, but no. It fucking winds me up.
you might as well yell at me. I've been getting yelled at for a couple weeks now. But the good news out of all this is, the bad news is the Europa show unfortunately got canceled. It did. The Europa people couldn't... you know, and this is the same stuff that the Olympia and the Arnold have been going through for years with this, you know, with this asshat, Al Thompson. It's the same stuff. He's been pulling.
He's been at it a long time.
He's been at it since 2008, since IFSA folded, since his shipping, buddy got screwed with the IFSA bill because of the South Korean debacle. I mean, this stuff is fucking old and tired. This stuff is so old that most of the people that are actually competing in the amateur ranks of strongman probably weren't even around when Al Thompson started.
Yeah, they don't know what this is about or who this is.
That's right.
I agree.
This has been going on for a long time. But the people are stepping up, I got to say. Ashley Howe Smith, she's organizing. She's out there. They're writing letters to these to all these people that sponsored Resolution 626, and they're just asking the question, why did you include strongman in this? Yes, we agree that performance-enhancing drugs are bad for kids. Why are you saying strongman? I mean, why are you stopping there? Why isn't it baseball? Why isn't it powerlifting? Why, you know, whatever the thing. And I don't want to get into the whole thing where why isn't it like league softball? Why aren't you testing for league softball? Because I guarantee you the guys that are out there doing league softball are smoking dope. They're doing coke. They're definitely drinking beer. And probably a few of them have been to their HRT doc, you know, but who cares? It's league softball. Strongman is such a small, tiny little niche. And the reason that there's no drug testing in strongman is because none of the promoters can afford it. Because this is stuff that people do on their own time, on their backyard. They train and they compete for the love of the sport. This isn't some big time multi-billion dollar enterprise. Anybody that thinks it is, you talk to any promoter that's been in this game for a while. You talk to Dion Wessels, talk to Colin Bryce, talk to Callie and Nick Best. They will tell you the big money just isn't there. At this point, it's for the love of the sport. And I got to be honest with you, I wasn't making a dime at the Europa, Chavez. I was doing it to give guys an opportunity and maybe to stick it to Dion just a little bit. Wah, wah, wah. But I was doing it to give guys an opportunity. And this poison pill comes along and really ruins it for everybody. But I don't think the strongman community is going to take this one lying down.
I certainly hope not. I'm sick of this kind of shit. I've been in strength sports literally. I walked into a commercial gym for the first time on Christmas Day, 1981. That's how long I've been doing this shit. And every couple of years, every 10 years or so, some douchebag arrangement like this comes up. And I'm just sick of it. And I hope eventually – There's enough constitution collectively out there to set things right, at least a little right. Because right. I probably sound less bitter than even I am. I fucking hate this nonsense. Yeah. It's ridiculous. It's embarrassing.
Well, and it really calls, you know, it doesn't. One of the things is if you read the letters, and again, you can go to the RX Power Hour Facebook page and see all of the legal documents. None of this stuff is like, well, I heard that this guy said this and this guy did that. This is all stuff that really happened. It was documents that were sent, you know, letters to senators, a letter to me telling me that the event was canceled, a letter from the Europa talking about Al Thompson's potentially illegal actions and the way that he conducted himself. You know, that slander, libel, all those types of things are thrown around. But this is all real stuff. So I was just wanting to give that information to people. But yeah, you can absolutely check that out and see all that information is there. But stand by. We're not done yet. We're gonna make sure. But here's something, Chavez. You ready for this shit?
Go ahead. Hit me with it.
My fucking the phone rings at my office today, and I pick it up. And who and the guy hangs up, and I look at the caller ID. Al Thompson called my place of work. So I'm telling you. So all you promoters, you got to watch out. And if you don't believe me, you get on here and you talk to Steve Puccinella from Iron Sport Gym, because Al used to be an employee of his. This is this guy's MO. He will try to call your job, make waves, wild accusations, just like he did at the Europa, to try to get you fired from your job. So if you're a strongman promoter and somehow you get on this, you know, turd bag's web, you know, radar, he's going to try to harass you, and he won't stop at just the fact, you know, if you have a campaign, Chavez, if you got a campaign against the sport and you don't like the sport because, you know, whatever the reason, that's fine. Go after the sport. You know, show up at the arena and protest. You know, stay within your legal rights. I mean, but don't make up stuff. Don't try to ruin people's lives, you know. But I guess, you know, when you're, you know, kind of decrepit and, you know, skeezy and sort of all alone and stuff, you don't have a life of your own. I mean, what better do you have to do, I suppose?
Well, that's the MO with all of these people, all of the crusaders. They're scorned usually by something other than the thing they're actually crusading against. You know, this asshole got burned financially and socially, perhaps, by what he interprets to be the world of strongman. And now he just has a general hate and loathing of people that are capable, muscular, athletic, and possibly even making money. So it's just general hate. It's pathetic people behaving pathetically.
Well, you know, Chavez, we deal in facts here. Far be it for me to spread rumor or innuendo. However, Big Rimmer 285 AOL was Al Thompson's former handle when he was trolling for Harry Bears. He's a well-known Harry Bear guy. In fact, he's the guy that and Chad Coy made a post on this just yesterday, because Chad Coy's been in the sport really, like, seriously longer than anybody. He's actually competed in some Thompson shows. Well, that's the other thing too. Thompson was a promoter, and he had some big time promotions with like Zdrunas Savickas, Travis Ortmeier. I mean, the list of people that competed in his 2006 show, I mean, it looks like it could have been World's Strongest Man. And not once, all the way up until 2012, did he ever test for anything. And what he did, though, was he exploited these athletes, because he had his buddies out there that were photographers, and all these athletes ended up on gay websites. Yeah, wow. All the Harry Bear websites. Yeah. I mean, not that there's anything wrong with being gay, homosexual, whatever, whatever, but that's exploitation of athletes, and that's what Al was doing. Dion continues that, by the way, because her photographer for a long time had been a Harry Bear guy. And so part of the deal was he would come take the pictures for free, but he would get rights to the pictures. So, you know, there's German gay porn sites with strong men all over it. So whatever.
You know what I mean? Well, nice to know there's money in strong men.
Oh, man.
You know, and I just want to throw in some random sprinklings on what you – all the things you've said.
Please.
And I agree with everything you've said, and I'm really ashamed and embarrassed for you, because this shit isn't right, and it's a shame that it falls on your lap and you know, lose an enterprise, potentially lose revenue, and the sport itself loses – you know, stout in position and forward momentum. So I'm embarrassed for all of that. But just randomly, you know, this whole thing, like, oh, the Wessels crime syndicate and strongman's promoting drugs. You know what? I want to be clear. I'm going to make an admission that I don't think is surprising to anyone. I fucking use drugs. Okay, I use and have all through my career used for fucking performance-enhancing drugs. You know what, folks? It's fucking hard to find. There's no big syndicate out there trying desperately to mail me drugs. That shit ain't happening. Okay, that's bullshit. This guy's got his head way up his ass because it's fucking work. It's effort, okay? So that's just fucking stupid. Stupid in a way I can't even articulate. But, oh, Jesus, I'm going to have a fucking stroke right now. You know what? I'm fucking ranting about it. That's going to be the headline. Fucking Al Thompson's going to have that all over.
Yeah, that's right.
Fucking radio strongman. Fucking heart attack while ranting about drugs. Yeah. Warn your children. Any fucking way. Jesus Christ.
This is a beautiful segue for you, too. Let's see if we can actually get Chavez's blood pressure up. Because far be it for the government to be fucking in charge of anything, Food and Drug Administration came out and said, eating foods with cholesterol in them isn't necessarily bad for you. Yet they're fucking poisoning us with the statin drug, Chavez. So eat all the eggs you want. Egg it up, kids.
Well, that whole thing, I mean, I am not like one of these conspiracy people that thinks like the government's like out to get us or whatever, but the whole cholesterol thing was the height of stupid people listening to stupid people that couldn't understand simple science. If anybody out there that knows some history, they could back me up on this. There was a guy named Ansel Keys. He was a biochemist in the 30s through 50s, and he was a real smart guy, and he did all kinds of groundbreaking stuff, but he also did really weird shit that really didn't have any relevance. He just did it because it was science that needed to be done. And one of the things he did is he took rabbits, furry little herbivorous little animals. They do not eat meat. They do not eat fat of any kind. They eat fucking greens. They eat lettuce and grass and what the fuck ever they eat in the wild. Ansel Keys took rats and fed them cholesterol. And lo and behold, these poor animals that had absolutely no metabolic ability to deal with cholesterol wound up with all sorts of vascular inflammation and atherosclerosis and all sorts of things. They fucking all died of heart attacks. Okay, so there was immediately, in Ansel Keys' mind, some sort of connection between cholesterol and the potential for cardiovascular disease. Not that cholesterol causes it, but it's in some way connected. Okay, but again, this study was done with fucking rabbits, folks. Not people, not pigs, not even rats. Fucking rabbits. And some nut job Seventh-day Adventist, and I don't want to bash religious people, although I could do that all day too, but that's a separate fucking thing. This some Seventh-day Adventist in that particular era's presidential administration grabbed a hold of this and used it for their own purposes to promote the idea that meat is bad and everyone should live on, you know, starches and carbohydrates, and got the ag growers unions around the nation on board and pushed legislation through demonizing meat products because of this guy's religious beliefs and the fact that he pitted one side of farm agra against the other. And that's how we got our stupid fucking food pyramid. It had nothing to do with real science. It certainly had nothing to do with cardiovascular disease. It was one retard's inability to understand that rabbits had nothing to do with humans and then pitting money against money. And that's how we got that. So here we are, 2000, whatever the fuck it is, 15, 65 years later, the government's finally figured out that 65 years of that program and the cardiovascular disease has quintupled, obesity is off the charts, and diabetes is, what, tripled since the 1950s, quadrupled, something like that.
Yeah.
So basically it's taken them a half a century to figure out that the shit they were saying didn't do much good and mostly bad.
Oops, our bad, people.
Yeah.
Y'all can start eating eggs again.
But thank God we have organized socialized health care to cover all the heart disease from the bad advice they've been giving us.
Woo-hoo! Obamacare!
So. So all right. It all dovetails together perfectly, really. So they are actually, you know, covering their bases, just in a very serendipitous roundabout way.
That's all right. And they're not Muslim terrorists or Islamic fanatics. They're just misunderstood, and they probably just need a job.
Right.
Anyway,
but that's the good. The upside of the FDA's thing. The upside is though they aren't actually telling us to drink more coffee, and I'm all over that.
Yes, we will come back to that and more. Coffee. Do you really have what's the thing? CNS? Is your CNS fatigued? My nervous system's breaking down. Oh man, I was lifting weights and my nervous system failed me.
I sprained
my nervous system. Coffee. Spraining.
Come over here and put some ice on it, will you?
Somebody give me a bag of ice for my nervous system. Coffee, spraining your nervous system, and much, much more. Hey, you know, we're going to talk about fucking strongman too, because I want to talk about those log lifts and compare side by side those three lockouts from that weekend. And we're going to talk about that and more. On the other side, I know we've got a guest, but hell, I don't even remember who it is. Probably our good friend Danny Dague from the XPC. He's going to be joining us coming up soon. You know who's going to be joining us? A buddy of yours.
A buddy of mine.
Beck.
Hey, there you go.
There you go. We're going to be talking about the Arnold. That's probably going to be on the next show. I really haven't worked that out yet. It depends on who answers the phone first. But anyway.
You're entertaining the enemy. You're inviting the enemy into our very domain, into the heart of the RX Power Hour.
Kale's not our enemy, is he? I thought Brian.
No, not really. He can sort it with the enemy.
Thought it was Brian Hildebrand was our enemy.
I don't have any enemies. I fucking hate everyone.
That's
equally.
Right, fuckers. Brian. Oh, you know, wait a minute. That's another thing. You know who finally got into the Al Thompson debate? Mr. Big, World's Strongest Radio Show himself. Brian Hildebrand graced one of the Facebook pages with his presence and all of his vast, vast knowledge of the situation.
It was kind of an unevent, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, I put up a post picture of Brian and Stewie dressed up in combat gear, and I said, "Welcome to the fight, Brian."
Well, you know, before you go to the break, I want to, you know, this whole thing, you know, children and steroids, and you know, we gotta, you know, let's keep past even the children. How many? Has there ever, I'm actually asking, and I'm pretty well-versed, is there anyone who's ever had a documented death associated with performance-enhancing drugs?
Well, okay, when you say performance-enhancing drugs, like, you know, I guess crystal meth, maybe cocaine, you know, there's probably some documented deaths to some of that.
Well, I'm being mildly facetious because I don't really consider long distance biking a sport. But actually, the first medically documented death in sports was a drug induced heroin. At the time, it was Lognum. It's that how far back in time it was. An actual long distance cyclist in Europe using Lognum to mask the pain and actually did have a heart attack.
Wow.
On wheels.
Well,
We're going back to like the 1870s.
Yeah, but
or something.
Go back further than that.
It was ludicrous.
I mean, the story of Marathon. You know, the guy.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, Marathon, that's where the name of running a marathon comes from.
Correct.
That guy ran
Marathon
there, passed off the information, he fucking died. So there you go.
But
performance-enhancing drugs.
All this talk of how terrible steroids are for you, I don't believe they've actually ever killed anyone.
No, they haven't. And that's, you know, again, that's part of the fake science that people hang their hats on.
No.
But we'll be back.
Sleep
apnea
and exaggerated body weights, and there's a lot of things that maybe have killed people, but I don't believe it's actually steroids. But anyway.
There you go. We'll be back with that and much more on the other side of this break. This is the RX Power Hour. Don't go away.
RX Power Hour, the first and last word in strength sports. Why? Because I said so.
When I get mad and I get good, I grab my pen and I write out a list of all the people that won't be missed. You make my shit worse. Oh,
Don't be fooled by the name. CheapSup.com carries high-quality supplements to help you lose weight, shed body fat, build muscle, and increase performance. Once a week, a surprise supplement will be released at a reduced price in a limited quantity. First come, first serve. Once it's gone, it's gone. From brand names like Species Nutrition, Dimatize, Blackstone Labs, Prime Nutrition, Sexy Strong, and more. Don't miss your chance. Be the first to snag these badass deals. Serving the United States only at this time. Click the banner or visit www.cheapsup.com.
Iron Mag Labs is the leading supplement company offering the most hardcore pro-anabolic supplements. Visit ironmaglabs.com and check out our top-selling products. Asta RX, Halo Extreme, Sinustain RX, E-Control RX, Decadrol Max, Ultramale RX. Iron Mag Labs makes supplements that actually work. No hype, no BS, just real results. There's a reason you keep hearing about Iron Mag Labs. Come see what you're missing. Visit Iron Mag Labs at Iron Mag Labs. Labs.com for the most hardcore bodybuilding supplements. Quest Bars from Quest Nutrition is Dave Palumbo's favorite protein bar. It's the only bar that's not simply a candy bar in disguise. There's no sugar or sugar alcohols, no soy, and zero trans fat. Quest Bars contain only the highest grade protein from whey and milk protein isolates. Quest Bars are also the lowest carb bar available, only 4 to 5 grams, and they all come from nuts. Quest Bars are also gluten-free. Quest Bars were specifically made for people who are serious about their physiques and who want the highest quality ingredients. Best of all, they taste great. Learn more about Quest Bars by visiting questproteinbar.com and try them out for yourself. Check out questproteinbar.com now.
All right, now, for all you boppers out there in the big city, all you street people with an ear for the action, I've been asked to relay a request from the Gramercy Riffs. It's a special for the Warriors. That's that real live bunch from Coney, and I do mean the Warriors. Here's a hit with them in mind.
All right, and welcome back to segment two of the RX Power Hour, already a power-packed show. We've been bashing everybody. We're not taking any prisoners. We're going to be breaking out the chairs, throwing people through tables, because it is right now XPC time with my good friend, Mr. Danny Dague. Danny, welcome to the show.
Hello, my Johnson. You know me very well. You know how I roll.
Yeah.
WWE style, but yeah. It's XPC style on our end, my brother.
That's right.
Yes.
I mean, getting to the, we got a lot to talk about. Big lifters, big weekend, the Arnold. This is, this is not your first rodeo putting on events, but every year, Danny, every year, the thing is growing, man. $15,000 prize money. That's signed, sealed, and delivered. That's not maybe. That's happening.
Oh, yes. We give away $1,500 to 8 different lifters this year, Mike, and $500 to 8 different second-place lifters. So I broke it down so everybody gets the shot at the $1,500 apiece. So you got $15,000, break it down, 8 different first-place giveaways at $1,500, and 8 different second-place giveaways at $500.
Dude, you really...
And that's the... You go ahead.
No, I was going to say, a lot of meets pay out the top guy, and basically the top guy shows up and just sort of collects his paycheck, but everybody's getting a taste of the gate, and you really are going to have to earn your keep here.
Oh yeah, you got to earn your keep, you got to be top dog, it's all done by formula, the sports formula we use for the men, and the let's see, we use Schwartz and Malone. So Malone will be for the females. Yeah, we got a lot of sponsors this year. NHP, Anderson Powerlifting, 1020 for Life. That'd be Brian Terrell's new gig there. Michigan Barbell's always a supporter. Captain Jack, I love this guy's logo. Check it out on the website at xbcpowerlifting.com. You'll see all these sponsors. Power Against Violence, that's Gene and Amy Richlack are real, real big supporters for that. Power Belly Gear, New Breed Nutrition, Overkill, and my own gym, Lexan Xtreme, and of course, Elite Fitness always helps out. But yeah, that's how we raised the money. I went out, I did my footwork, talked to all these people, and they come strong with the money this year.
Very nice, very nice. So a little bit of a different setup this year than in years past, of course, because, you know, the place that you used to hold it, did they finally tear that down? Is it gone?
Yes, that memorial is in process of getting ripped out of the ground, wow. Which is a big big hit for Columbus. But you know what? I thought it was going to be bad, but it come around to be good. We have a way better venue. It is at the Road Center, which is part of the Expo, Ohio Expo Center, which is the fairgrounds. And, you know, the Arnold and their staff is working real hard to build that, and they've got a lot of events over there. There's a new Kids Expo that's going to be part of that. So you can go over to the fairgrounds, get your shuttle back and forth to the Expo that's downtown, park right in front of the Road Center where we're at, 717 East 17th Avenue. And it's right there, right off the road. The parking is right out front. You can grab a shuttle. You want to go down and see the all the vendors downtown. You can take the shuttle down, come back, watch the powerlifting. It's all set up real nice this year, Mike.
Yeah, it seems like it's a better place, really, to start your day. You know, get a parking spot, start your day, and the Arnold has the shuttles going back and forth. And we've got 2 days of powerlifting, 2 days of full meet at the Road Center. Friday, the action kicks off. Who's lifting on Friday?
On Friday, it'll be, we call it the classic. This year, where we've added the classic. That's with just knee wraps and wrist wraps. We call it XPC Classic. We're starting to get a lot of good draw with the classic. So you'll see all the women and all the lightweight men on Friday morning starting about 8:30. And then we break, and we're going to run another session. So this will be all in sessions. So at 2:30, you'll see your multiply women and all your multiply lightweight men up to 2:20 right there.
Nice.
And that'll all happen on Friday. And then Saturday, 8 a.m., we'll start the classic heavyweight men, starting at 2:20 and up. And then the big dogs come out. My good friend Chuck Vogelpohl this year is going to be there. And
yeah.
At 2:30, the heavyweight multiply, which is my favorite part of the whole meet. And we've got some big names going there, Mike.
Nice.
We got Carroll, we got Vogelpohl, Helber, Jonathan Bird, Billings, Marcus Wilde. We've got Ken Wheatman, Jaron Breida, another one of my guys, Joey Grizz Rogers, Tony Pelzer. This kid won last year. He is a freak.
Yeah, definitely.
And Justin Graffs. Oh, he got hurt last year, but he's back and ready to go.
Wow, Justin.
Graffs out of, yes. Marshall Johnson's going to show up this year.
Wow.
Yeah. Alan Meehan from up there in Canada.
Nice.
And we've got another big name, Jake Anderson, stepping out of, he trains over at Westside Barbell.
Yes, he does.
Yes, it will be a battle, man.
Wow, that'll be exciting. So, you know, I know Brian Carroll has dropped down to 242. And I, as a matter of fact, not too long ago, I got a phone call from Chuck, weighing in at 242. I'm excited. I've been watching the videos, you know, Lexan Xtreme, for those of you that have been sleeping under a fucking rock. When I turned 40, I decided I was going to be done with strength sports. I was real lean. You know, I needed a shoulder surgery. I was a little bit dinged up, but I ended up moving to Columbus, Ohio. And I visited Lexan Xtreme, and you know, back then, shit. I mean, what was Matt's last name? Matt was still lifting there.
Matt Wenning. Yeah,
Matt Wenning. Chuck was lifting there. I mean, you know, Brandon Lilly passed through. Mike Cartinian has been there. You know, just basically, who's the guy, the man, the 240, Greg Panora. I mean, really, you know, even Hoff was there for a little while. Really, the who's who. I mean, you knew Lex and Xtreme, you know, and I had been to your meets before. I mean, you just knew it. And I got sucked back in there and did some of the best lifting of my career in Lex and Xtreme. But, you know, I've been watching. So I'm watching, keeping up. You know, a lot of my training partners, guys that I trained with, still lifting there. You really have a crew of people that is just kind of growing up right in front of me. Pat Helber. Now, Pat was a 220, good kid. He just got out of the Army when I was still at Lexan. And now he's really a 242 to be reckoned with. He's putting up some big numbers.
Yeah, he's come a long way. He's gonna show up this year. He's one of those kind of guys that just take things, you know, with a grain of salt. He doesn't get all excited, but buddy, he can put it together on the platform, Mike. He has come a long way. We've got a lot of new guys down at the gym now. Lexington is just a good place to train. We've got a good rapport out there with a lot of good people, a lot of professional guys. You know, got families, kids that are just a lot of good people. I'm fortunate to be in the Columbus area where there's a lot of powerlifters down here.
Oh, yeah.
And to have the guys that I've got, it helps me as a meet director to be able to run good meets, put on good shows. Because without those guys, and especially the guys that you don't see that just stand up there and help me and spot and load and load the truck and do all the grunt work, man, those guys, you know, I can't ask for better people.
No, your staff, the staff is what makes a meet. The guys that are out there getting it done, you know, you feed them, you give them a t-shirt, you know, throw them some cash if you got it in the budget, you take care of them, but it's never enough for what they do and what they put into a meet, you know what I mean?
No, you're right, and it's, you know, this sport is like that. You get a lot of guys that just help and support you as just be a part of it, and that's what makes it, man. Without those guys, I wouldn't be able to run meets, and, well, you know, we got it in the Arnold, and we're going nowhere, buddy. We're getting better and better. And, you know, everybody forgets the bench flip show sponsored by MHP.
Oh, no.
This is going
to
be.
Yeah. I didn't forget that, baby. I was getting to it.
Yeah, yeah. The main stage over at the Convention Center Sunday at 12:30 is when we'll start this year. Last year it was 11:30. This year they're backing up to 12:30. I think Strongman follows us or something like that. I haven't really got the whole schedule, but I just know we're there at 12:30. So if you want to see that, come over to Convention Center. That'll be the last day of the Arnold, and that'll be the big show with the Multiply Ventures.
Yeah, that's where you're going to see some big, big lifting, bench press wise. Now, you know, big benching at the Arnold is, you know, that those two things go hand in hand. But as it was, there was a lot of guys that they didn't even make their first attempt. They opened too big. They bombed out. You kind of have a system that that kind of forces the guys to get into the meet and then wow the crowd. Talk to me about that.
Well, you know what? I look at it like this. You know, that was one of the reasons why the Arnold staff says no more Multiply Bench, and they missed too much. So he says, can you make this happen? Can you make it work? And I said, I'll make it work. Came up the idea. You open with no more than 650. If you're lightweight, you have to open with at least 650 and go from there. So your opener has to be at least 650 if you're 198 and below. Anybody above that can open with no more than 800 pounds. So if you're heavyweight, we just have the opener set, and that's what made it work, Mike. It was a real good idea. It worked, and everybody has no problem with it. And then I just let them go for broke after that. They seem to respond real well, and a lot of them made their lifts last year. Not too many guys missed their opener, so...
No, that's correct.
It came across real well, and we're back again.
Now, last year you had the young Russian lady, the young girl, I should say, who got up there and had some fun with us. But, you know, who are we looking for this year? Who's lifting on the big stage?
She's returning, as usual, and Tom Waltrip. Most of the guys that were there last year are returning.
Okay.
Kim Hensley, I'm talking about all the lightweights. Greg Powell, Eric Canis, Gene. Now I'm going to tear his name up. The bitch. Anyway, he's a Russian.
Oh, very good.
I can't wait. He's the one that won last year.
Yeah, Gene the Russian. Got it.
Yeah. Chris Smith was going to be in it. He got hurt. He came out. Alan Bria also got hurt. We lost those two guys. Walmack's coming back, Jimmy Kolb, Matt Hauser, those guys will all be battling at the big 9-950 range.
Right.
So it's a pretty good lineup. We're down, we can only have 10, so that gives us 10, and that's perfect. The last year we kind of went over our time limit, and they were yelling at me, so I had to kind of cut it back a little bit.
Yeah, well, we're good to go with 10. We'll run them through pretty quick. Be taking care of the music and making some noise up on the big stage. It is amazing. I'm excited for the new venue. Honestly, I think it's going to be, there's a lot going on at the Rhodes Center, at that whole Ohio Expo Center at the Rhodes, where we're going to start our event on Friday and Saturday. And I think that people are going to stay around there. You got the Kids Expo going on. You got some other lifting events. You said Mariah's running some stuff. There's a lot to see there. But the fact that people can grab a shuttle, go, come back, not have to fight the crowds downtown, I think that's going to make for a hell of a couple of days. And really some big, big numbers I think we're going to see on Saturday. I'm excited. I'm excited to see Jake. I got to train with him a couple times while I was still in Ohio, and he's just a big, strong dude.
Yeah, him and Chris Jackie, the winner of last year's 308s, they're going to be going at it. This Chris Jackie is no joke. He kind of, lays low all year. He says the only meat he really does is mine. And Jake, at 308, that will be a battle that everybody should come out and see. And what you say about the Road Center, the good thing about the Road Center is when you get off the freeway, you come down, and the parking is right there. So you can come in and watch the XPC finals, and then the shuttle's out front. It's free of charge, and you can go anywhere in Columbus. The wristband that you gets you in anywhere down there. So, it's free reign to go anywhere. We're in a good location for where we're at. And if you want to park where we're at, it's $6 versus 20 downtown. So,
oh, yeah, for sure.
You're going to save a ton of money just on parking alone.
Yeah, and they got the shuttles running all day, so it really seems like it's going to work out well. Just a great setup. So, I've been watching the videos, and you can never tell from the videos, but my boy Chuck, how's he looking? I mean, he's meaner than ever, I'm sure.
He's meaner than ever. I seen him tonight. He had a stomach flu, and he got over it. He said it was a 24-hour thing. He was in there training tonight. The guy's a freak. He's been my friend since 1984. He's never changed. He's always been a very intense person. But then on the foot side, he's a real good dude to be around, especially when you're kicking it at the restaurants with a couple beers or whatever. But yes, he is back from a very, very intense back surgery. You know more about the surgery probably than I do.
It, so. Very, very, very intense. I have his last squat session. Now, 800 pounds. For me and you, because we're a couple of old guys, 800 pounds is a lot of weight. To most of the people, 800 pounds is a lot of weight. In the Chuck Vogelpohl lexicon, 800 pounds is not a lot of weight. But I have a video of his last 800-pound squat before the surgery, and you could see the guy struggled. I mean, not struggled technically, not struggled because it was heavy, but because he was in pain. But he was fucking flawless. His technique was flawless. I've been watching the videos, and he's a crazy person. I have no idea. He thinks he says if he says, and this is Chuck, if he does it right, if he hits it perfectly, he's in the 1,100-pound range. And I was just damn.
You're right.
Damn.
And that's his goal. That's his goal. I talked to him tonight. He said he's looking at Oakland with about 10-20, and that's his goal, to squat 1,100 pounds. I don't see why he couldn't do it. I mean, he had a couple of his training sessions were a little off, but it was because of the new gear he's got. Overkill has come, Rudy has come around and helping Chuck out with a lot of new gear. So he has dropped the Enzer gear and is using Overkill, which this Overkill gear, man, if you learn that stuff, it works. Well, that stuff is really good gear right there.
That's what I was going to ask you, because he was mentioning something. One of the things that I had always found with the Enzer briefs and certainly the Leviathan, it was very forgiving within 10 pounds. If you were down a little bit, in weight, you could just crank those straps down, and that gear would really work for you. If you were up a little bit in weight, as long as you could shove your fat ass into the suit, you know, and loosen those straps up, you know, you might have to pack a whole bunch of weight more on your back, but you were good to go. Chuck was telling me that really, he didn't mention a learning curve, but I want to know about that. He said though, it's not real forgiving with weight shifts. He says, you know, because a lot of my Inzer gear is Chuck hand-me-downs, quite honestly. He says this stuff almost has to be tailor-made to your body.
Well, you know, I'll tell you this about Overkill, the experience I've had around Rudy. Rudy comes to the meets. Rudy's in the warm-up room. Rudy's one of us. He is a gear, you know, he sells gear, and he makes gear, but he's one of us. He's right there in the warm-up room watching us. Watching his guys, all his sponsor lifters, he knows them. He tailor makes it right there. He measures you up. That's why it fits you perfectly.
Wow.
And
okay.
It's very extreme. So, you know, I give Rudy credit. He's one of us. He's in the warm up room. He's at the meets. He's not sitting behind a phone somewhere having somebody sew his stuff up. He's right there. He does it. You know, he's the guy who sews your gear up.
Gotcha.
And that's what I like about Overkill. He is one of us, and he's right there. And that's the way to go today. If you're going to be a multi-ply guy, you better get a hold of Rudy, because he's got the stuff, buddy.
Well, there you go. That's a big endorsement. I mean, coming from really folks that, you know, had been really lifting with, you know, different gear for years and years and years. I mean, that's something big to say.
Yeah, he is. It's the way to go. It takes you some time to get your order in, but it's because he's the one doing it. You know.
Yeah, I got you.
He doesn't have a staff of people that sit at sewing machines. It's him. I mean, he takes the time and individually makes that gear. So if you're a Overkill guy, be patient. It will come, and that's because it's hands on, right there with Rudy. And you know, I'll give him credit, buddy.
Yeah, that's awesome. So, you know, there's a lot of, I've been here lifting in the Indiana area, and I'm just training, just regular guy. You and I talked about this the other day. But I got a buddy that's training, and he's doing some, I guess you would call it your classic stuff. The knee wraps that are out these days are ridiculous. Now, I know, Danny, kind of coming from that West Side model, if you will, knee wraps really never went on until they had to. You know what I mean?
Right.
But these days, holy shit. Some of these knee wraps are incredible. They're insane. What are you guys using the old school stuff? Are you getting into any of these Anderson, he's got these green knee wraps. I have one of the kind of prototypes. It's a 3 meter. It's ridiculous. I mean, it's crazy. It's absolutely insane.
And I think the reason why with Anderson gear, he's got real good knee sleeves, knee wraps. I mean, I got to give Tim credit too. You know, he's one of the hands-on guys that's right there and helping us out. And yeah, the knee wraps, I think, have gotten better due to the fact a lot of guys are going raw now. And
right.
the raw guy has to rely on the knee wrap.
Absolutely.
You know, more than the suited guy relies on the suit and the wraps. But yeah, the knee wraps have gotten really extreme, and I think it's because the raw has really picked up, and you know, that a lot of the raw guys really depend on a real tight wrap because they get the spray out of the bottom. You know, by the way, you'll see quite a few pretty good lifters at the raw. We got a couple out of Alexa that are freaks. I mean, it freaks me out the weight these guys are lifting with no gear.
Yeah,
and it never was around much back when I was lifting. You'd see it some, wasn't talked about much. You know, we were always in some kind of gear.
Yeah,
and
for sure.
Today, it was really taken off. We want the XPC to be a big part of that, and we are this year for the first time. So hopefully that'll be, you know, as raw, what we call classic, XPC classic, will grow. And next year we can really get a big draw on the classic.
Gotcha.
But yeah, the D-Wrap, you're seeing a lot of attempts, a lot of different companies, the Power Belly, that's what they are. They're a D-Wrap, wrist wrap company. You know, a lot of the stuff has gotten better, and wow, I don't know where the end is, Mike.
Yeah, I hear you. You know, and I've been around, like I say, training with some guys that are raw and kind of, you know, just sort of helping them along the way and doing a little bit of raw training. But it is different. I mean, everything about it is different, from, you know, the speed of movement to your foot placement to, you know, even in some cases your bar placement, or even what bars you use. You know what I'm saying? It's just a different world. But yeah, these kids are strong. Kids are incredibly strong.
We got a new kid at the gym. His name is Tanner Heisel. Took him to his first meet out of Lexington, and he totaled a pro total, XPC pro total, at the very first meet.
Wow.
Squatted 700, pulled 780, and benched a 405, and he's brand new. He's 23 years old. He's done two meets in his whole life. One of those is under our banner, and he did real well. So he's going to be at the Arnold. This Aaron Coco, little guy, used to be a little guy, now he's 220. You're looking to see a guy at 220, Mike, totaling probably $2,000.
Wow. That's
at a light 220.
That's huge.
You know, that's huge, and I don't know how they do it. I mean, I stand and watch. I'm like, that's pretty impressive. You know, I'm a multiply guy by heart, but the raw has threw me for a loop the way these guys are coming up with these big numbers.
Yeah, it's exciting. I saw, you know, it was a different powerlifting promoter, but they had, you know, a meet last year. I went to it. It was a good meet. It was a fun meet, whatever. But the most impressive meet, the most impressive lift of the day was not the multiplied guys. It was some guy squatting 900 pounds raw. I mean, I was standing, you know, just, a few feet away from him, and I watched it with my own eyes. I mean, I got a videotape. I think it was Daniel Bell. Because he's a big kid. He's a big kid, but he's not any bigger maybe than anybody else I've ever seen. You know, so like back in the day when you looked at Kaz, I mean, he was just huge and he was bigger than the guys he competed against. Or these guys were so big and so muscular, you know, back in the, I guess they wore gear. They wore real thin gear, whatever. But this kid was big, but he just, you know, I wasn't going to be like, oh my God, he wasn't like Brian Shaw, a strongman big, you know, but he got up under that weight and crushed that 900 with some speed, put a little hot sauce on that. And I was like, what is going on? It's pretty amazing. It's pretty amazing, but.
Yeah, it is amazing. You know, I forgot to mention at the last minute here, we were working a lot with Detroit Barbell and Minnesota with the, you've heard of the Relentless program,
yes,
right?
Yes, I have.
You know, Detroit is very big supporter of XPC, and we're a supporter of what they do. They're a big part of that, Relentless, and there will be a booth at the Arnold this year taking donations for that cause, for the sick kids. And, you know, it's nothing, like, I'm not taking away from, it was their idea. This was not a Relentless meet, but it will support the Relentless program. And we're all about that. If it's going to help the kids, you know, we're all for it. So
that's all right. Anybody that's cool.
We want people to come out, throw a couple bucks in the jar out there and support
absolutely
the sick kids with cancer. Because, you know, we always go up there and try to lift in that meet every year. And it's a good cause for powerlifting, you know.
When's the last time you did a meet?
I did a meet. I went to Relentless 2013. And then after that, I had some health issues and had to regroup there for a little bit. I had to rethink what I was doing. But, you know, I'm getting older. I'm 55 now, and I had my best meet when I was 50 years old, total over $2,000, you know, out there in New York at the IPA.
Yeah.
And, you know, that I think that was my heyday. And I can settle with that.
Yeah,
you know?
I got you.
But I might do something, you know. I might try I doubt if I try the raw thing, but I might put maybe some single ply gear back on if I get healthy again and see what I can do. I don't know. We'll have to take that.
we should go up and do the Relentless meet because it sounds like it's just fun. Get a couple old guys up there just lifting some weights and just see how it goes.
Well, you know what, Mike? That would be the meet I'd go to. It'd be Relentless. Just, you know, you raise money on your, you build a website or like a Facebook page. And people donate money to your page. You have to have a $500 entry to get in. And that usually comes from donations from friends and family or whatnot.
There you go.
And all that money goes to the kids. And we go up there every year. And if things go right, that's where I'll go. And,
that's it.
You know.
That's a beautiful
thing. Try to do my thing up there. Yeah.
Hell yeah. That's a beautiful thing. So we got 3 days of Xtreme Powerlifting Coalition. We've got Friday, we've got Saturday, and we've got on the main stage at the Arnold, we got Sunday, we got the big benching. You got the Raw Classic with the ladies in the morning, 8 o'clock Friday, and then you've got your Multiply and your Lightweight Men. You have your Raw Classic with the ladies and the Lightweight Men Friday morning, 8 o'clock. Then 2:30-ish, we're going to be hitting the Multiply with the women and the Lightweight Men. And then Saturday, 8 o'clock, we've got the Raw Classic, the class XPC Classic on Saturday at 8 o'clock. And then at 2:30, we got the big studs. We got the real deal, the 1,100-pound squats. And then at 12:30, just there to go watch Chuck Vogelpohl lift again. Brian Carroll, too, coming off the big back injury, but he's been back in the game, hitting some big numbers. These are guys that I know personally. So just that is worth the price of admission for me. And then on Sunday, 12:30, the big bench up on stage, 10,000 people in that auditorium screaming and yelling, the music playing, blistering, melting your face off. It's Xtreme, man. This is what it's all about.
Keep in mind, listeners, anybody listening, Mike Johnson is our MC.
That's right,
and he's
baby.
The best MC that I've ever came across.
There we
this
go.
This man here, yep, he's the best. He makes the show, baby. Ooh, the BXPC, yeah.
we're gonna have a good time, baby. Xtreme Powerlifting Coalition at the Arnold again, Friday and Saturday at the Ohio Expo Center at the Rhodes Center portion of it. Got your own building. 717 East 17th Street, 8 a.m. Friday. Not going to want to miss it. You can park out there for $6. Shuttles running back and forth to the Arnold. You can only be in that expo hall for so long with all the freaks walking around. I mean, it's cool and all, but for the love of God. Jeez.
For the love of God.
it's just too crowded in there sometimes. But you can indeed check out the Kids Expo and come out check out some of the badass powerlifting, the best on the planet, with Danny Dague and XPC. So people definitely want to do that.
Right.
And one more time with these sponsors, MHP and Anderson Powerlifting, your big title sponsors. You've got 1020 Life, Brian Carroll's new joint, Michigan Barbell, Captain Jacked, a Revolution Powerlifting, Power Against Violence and Abuse. There is no excuse. Gene Richlack, of course, he will be there, and his lovely wife will also be in the hizzy. Power Belly Gear, New Breed Nutrition. You can check them out, newbreednutrition.com. Of course, Overkill Strength Equipment, supporting a lot of the guys that'll be out there lifting. Elite FTS, educating and outfitting the strongest athletes around the world. And of course, the hometown gym, Lexan Xtreme, Danny Dave.
Yes.
I'm excited, man. I'm definitely excited. I'm proud to be part of it, brother.
Hey, you know what? We're proud to have you, Mike. We are excited. This is going to be the best one yet. This is our third year. Now, the fourth year is going to be even bigger and better. So if you're a powerlifter and you want to be part of the Arnold, you better come out next year.
That's right.
If you haven't done it this year, because we're going to have more money. It's the best meet in the country. I mean, what other better venue than the Arnold? There is none.
That's right.
You can say what you want to say, but the Arnold Classic, if you've got powerlifting involved with them, you're the number one meet. There's no doubt about it. I mean, there's no better venue. Never will be. Never have been. It's the Arnold.
There it is.
XPC style.
And $15,000 given away to boot. And you can make a donation to Relentless. So plenty of good things going on. Danny, I look forward to it, checking in with you again before the meet. Try to get that list of those people up on stage and really put on a show for that bench press event. What are you calling that this year? We calling it Xtreme.
It's the MHP XPC Bench Finals.
MHP.
We like to call it the Freak Show.
The Freak Show Finals, baby. I like it. Freak Show
Finals. The NXT Freak Show Finals.
That's it. We'll be there on Sunday. So a lot of good stuff coming up. Please come and check it out. Danny Dague, thank you for your time. I appreciate it. I look forward to seeing you out there. Yeah. And oh, you know, you should probably thank your wife. I'm just saying.
I'm just saying, you know what? You're absolutely right. That, you know, if a wife's happy, everybody's happy.
If mama's happy, everybody's happy. That is so true.
That's the way it goes across the board. I don't care what any of you are saying out there.
Yeah, I don't care how big and bad you are. If your old lady's pissed, your day's ruined.
Right. Honey, I'm going to be hard on the place. Oh, really?
No, you're not.
Yeah. We all know.
Yeah, no doubt. All right, one more time, the XPC at the Arnold. Third year, third time's the charm. Big money. Come check it out Friday, Saturday, and Sunday on the main stage.
That's right, baby.
With the MHP XPC Freak Show Finals on the bench. Yours truly, Mikey J. I will be in the house making some noise, tearing it up, beating up that microphone from the inside out. Danny, thanks very much for coming and hanging out with me. Always a pleasure.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, my friend. I'll see you in a week.
Yeah, just a little over a week. Well, yeah.
Everybody get out there. Everybody come on out.
Yep. There's no place to be but the Arnold. If you're into strength, that's where you need to be. But this is the RX Power Hour. We will be right back with segment three, some more soothing sounds from Hugo. We got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one.
If you haven't got problems, I feel bad for your son. I got 99 problems and a bitch ain't one. Tip my hat to the sun in the west. Feel the beat right in my chest. At the crossroads a second time. Make the devil change his mind. But it's really a ton. 99 problems and a bitch ain't one. If you haven't got problems, I feel bad for your son. I got 99 problems and a bitch ain't one. 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one.
Don't be fooled by the name. CheapSup.com carries high-quality supplements to help you lose weight, shed body fat, build muscle, and increase performance. Once a week, a surprise supplement will be released at a reduced price in a limited quantity. First come, first serve. Once it's gone, it's gone. From brand names like Species Nutrition, Dimatize, Blackstone Labs, Prime Nutrition, Sexy Strong, and more. Don't miss your chance. Be the first to snag these badass deals. Serving the United States only at this time. Click the banner or visit www.cheapsup.com.
Iron Mag Labs is the leading supplement company offering the most hardcore pro-anabolic supplements. Visit ironmaglabs.com and check out our top-selling products. Asta RX, Halo Extreme, Sinustain RX, E-Control RX, Decadrol Max, Ultramale RX. Iron Mag Labs makes supplements that actually work. No hype, no BS, just real results. There's a reason you keep hearing about Iron Mag Labs. Come see what you're missing. Visit Iron Mag Labs at ironmaglabs.com for the most hardcore bodybuilding supplements. Quest Bars from Quest Nutrition is Dave Palumbo's favorite protein bar. It's the only bar that's not simply a candy bar in disguise. There's no sugar or sugar alcohols, no soy, and zero trans fat. Quest Bars contain only the highest grade protein from whey and milk protein isolates. Quest Bars are also the lowest carb bar available, only 4 to 5 grams, and they all come from nuts. Quest Bars are also gluten-free. Quest Bars were specifically made for people who are serious about their physiques and who want the highest quality ingredients. Best of all, they taste great. Learn more about Quest Bars by visiting questproteinbar.com and try them out for yourself. Check out questproteinbar.com now.
Anger, hostility towards the opposition. 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 Anger, hostility towards the opposition.
Anger, hostility towards the opposition. Anger, hostility towards the opposition. Anger, hostility towards the opposition. Anger, hostility towards the opposition. Anger, hostility towards the opposition. Anger, hostility towards the opposition. Anger, hostility towards the opposition. Anger, hostility towards the opposition.
Welcome, welcome again, friends. We are back, segment three. This is the time where we get to answer your questions, but there aren't any. You know, there have been some questions. Who the hell's Al Thompson? Is this for real? This can't be real. I can't believe in America this kind of thing can happen. Does Europa have any nutsack at all? You know, there's all kinds of stuff. Ooh, this is interesting. Steve Puccinella says, by the way, I know where this guy lives if anybody wants to pay him a visit and punch him in the face. We're certainly not condoning that, but it's out there. Shauna Mendelson just straight up says, douche. She's, you know, she is very verbose. I love Shauna. She definitely, Steve Dana says, that guy needs a beating. All right, then. Well, we're going to stay away.
I'll set him up with the address. And
yeah, we're going to, we'll have a bunch of happy campers. Yeah. But we are back. We are back indeed. And this is something interesting. My good friend, Donnie Thompson, I love when he rants and raves, you know, and if you don't lift at West Side, you can't do West Side. I don't know if that's exactly true. If you've ever lifted at West Side, I try.
Well, I don't have the shoes for it.
Yeah. We don't have the Chuck Taylors. I trained with Chuck Vogelpohl for a long time, and I don't know if exactly what we were doing was West Side, but I have every inclination that there were some West Side ish principles in it. But for that matter, I trained with Donnie Thompson for a long time, and we definitely did some West Side, you know, conjugate method stuff and all kinds of other crazy shit that he would go to some seminar, meet some crazy Russian person in a back room. Next thing you know, our training style would completely change. I really didn't have a problem with that because I just think random training, you know, with a little bit of focus on technique gets you strong, and a little bit of focus on technique gets you through the meat. But, The conversation came up about, you know, a central nervous system overload. And Donnie was poo-pooing that as poppycock, that really doesn't happen. And, you know, as a therapist, people say, oh, my central nervous system. And I always tend to think of central nervous system injuries that are paralysis or even peripheral damage, Guillain-Barré syndrome, you know, something like that, you know, muscular dystrophy. And so when I think of those, when I think of injuries of that nature, you know, even a bulging disc, or a herniated disc, or somebody that's had a back injury, fuck, sciatica. Oh, my sciatica, Chavez, you know, something like that. I think of as central nervous system, but you know, everybody hangs their hat on central nervous system fatigue. Can you expound perhaps and, educate the masses, because remember, this is the portion of the program we do answer questions, but we're also all about education.
Wow, I never thought I'd be fall under the heading of educator.
Wow,
I'm still chuckling to myself, yeah. Folks. All you people, you get to listen to this show in its edited form. You really miss out on the funny shit we say during the commercials. So I'm still fucking entertained from that. Well, and I'm not really have my head screwed on properly for this question. But
all right, but
before, nervous system,
okay,
central nervous system fatigue.
All right, hold on. You can't bring that up and just leave that hanging out there. Everybody's wanting to know what the fuck. What is Chavez talking about now? Before the breaks, we were talking about obviously performance enhancing drugs, and one of the things that I read and I was telling Chavez over the weekend is because one of the things that Al says, there's been nine strongman athletes that have died directly from steroids. Never proven, none of it has been. One guy said that there were more deaths in the United States because people had gotten
in bed sheets.
Right, people had gotten entangled in their bed sheets and had suffocated. I can't even believe that. But then we started talking about death by masturbation. And I was like, oh, come on. Now, the French have a word for that. Little deaths in French. It sounds so much cooler in French. Little deaths. Let me see if I can look that up while we're talking. But little deaths when you ejaculate, when your brain goes completely empty, devoid of thought, and you're just right there in the moment, and they call that little deaths. And I'm just trying to see what the French word is here. Oh, of course, I'm not going to get it. But anyway, so we were talking about, death by masturbation. And, of course, Chavez produces a list of 13 confirmed deaths through auto.
Medically and science confirmed.
Confirmed through auto.
Actual coroner report confirmed deaths.
Autoerotica. So, yes, kids, not only will you go blind, but there's a small chance, yet real chance, that you will die while jerking off. So, or maybe for the girls too, because there was a couple women that had died in that same.
Yeah, absolutely.
So if you're at home, sweeties, ladies, rubbing one out, be careful. Make sure you got some
oxygen.
Apparently,
sex toys do have an upper limit on size and bulk.
You really can impale yourself. I mean, that's not just an urban legend. Anyway, but I digress.
But anyway, back to point.
Yeah, back to the point. Central nervous system.
Maybe that's where my central nervous fatigue comes from.
Perhaps.
I never thought of that.
Perhaps.
But anyway. Okay, I am going to talk a little bit about central nervous fatigue, and for the most part, it's absolute and total lack of presence in the world of sports. And then I'm actually going to add to the conversation with something that might actually be relevant. Anyway, central nervous system fatigue. Your central nervous system, medically, is defined as your brain, brainstem, and spinal cord. Everything else is peripheral nervous system. Basically, it's like the motherboard, the computer chip, the memory, and then, the what's in computer world called the bus. It's that would be the spinal cord, the part that distributes the information. Then everything else is a peripheral nerve, meaning sensory or motor control, something like that. The absolute truth is, can these things be overtaxed? The answer is, in fact, yes. The problem with it is the human body, biologically and evolutionarily, is so well designed with checks and balances that it is almost impossible to do that under normal conditions. When I say normal conditions, that would be something like without supportive gear. A normal strength athlete, their absolute limit squat, let's just throw out a random 700 pounds. This person cannot squat 705 pounds. They can squat 700 pounds in contest under perfect conditions. So all of their training lifts building up to that are to some degree of a lower percentage. They're not going to be squatting 750 pounds in training to squat 700 pounds on the platform. Therefore, if 700 pounds is their limit, their nervous threshold is higher than that. Therefore, they'll never approach, 80, 90, 100% of their nervous capability. So they're always within that margin of safety, predesigned, predisposed by nature. The only time you can actually cross that threshold, well, there is one exception, and that would be plyometrics, where by jumping, what was originally actually called properly shock training, is by generating that violent shock from falling at 32 feet per second squared, you can actually load more force into your body than your limit strength would allow. And you can, in fact, overwhelm your nervous system. You can do the same thing with supportive equipment. If you are, say, that same 700-pound squatter with properly applied lifting gear, you might be able to squat, say, 900 pounds, which could, in fact, exceed your nervous thresholds. It's a rare condition. It would only show up in geared lifters, and it's corrected by things like conjugate method, proper programming, periodization. So it's really not an issue. It's really not a big deal. And here's the really, really relevant part of it is the nervous system is wildly robust, probably the most robust part of, you know, chordates and mammals. If you were in any way to approach some sort of nervous system inroad, literally hours or days of rest and it's gone. It's not something that's so systemic. So it's literally, if you could actually manage to do it to yourself, you just need a day off.
Yeah. So basically, Donnie's right. You know, everybody is complaining about their nervous system being overloaded. You're pretty much full of crap. But in a rare instance, you know, with a geared lifter, and a lot of these folks, you know, geared lifters kind of complain of that stuff. You know, you could overtax your system to that degree. You know, I never...
It is possible.
I never used to get super, super sore. Like, if I do squats with, you know, 405 pounds, and I do a bunch of reps and some volume training, you know, I'm maybe wearing a belt, and that's it. No knees, sleeves, no nothing. My muscles will get very sore. If I squat 700-800 pounds in briefs, my muscles don't get sore. My upper back, where I was holding the bar, gets sore, but not even sore like muscular sore, but like acute trauma sore. My joints will be sore. My knees will feel some deep soreness from increased pressure, because even though I had the briefs on and they were supporting my hips, my knees were pretty much left to their own devices, and still, my hips for that matter too, still felt that increased pressure. Obviously the low back, the spine.
Yeah.
So
in my vernacular, I would call that mechanical stresses.
And I think that's what people, I theorize that that is what people, confuse with, with central nervous system fatigue.
And there is even a, and what I was originally going to address, I'm going to put off for a second and say this. There's also the possibility of getting nervous distress, peripheral nerve distress, meaning pain in the forearms, you know, from pain downstream. That typically comes from those aforementioned mechanical stresses,
yes,
causing localized inflammation,
your sciatica,
which can then seriously piss off nerves downstream.
Well,
but that is not your central nervous system. Your central nervous system is your fucking brain, brainstem, and spinal cord. And let me tell you, if you hurt that, you're fucked up, folks.
Oh yeah,
but you're laying in traction. You're fucked up.
Yeah. Well,
that's this. People throw these casual terms around. Oh, you know, my central nervous system. Dude, if you don't have a brain tumor, I don't really want to hear about your brain. You don't have a problem.
Yeah. Well, you're correct. I mean, if you're lifting in a shirt and you're holding 700 pounds out over your body, and you know, you start to have some nerve pain in your elbow and your ulnar nerve and stuff, that's because it's just, you know, your forearms, even though you've maybe have wrist wraps on, you know, fuck, 700 pounds, that's not even a lot. Guys are holding 8, 9, 1,000. I think there's a video of Dave Hoff. Dave Hoff doing a 1080 to a half board just the other day, preparing for a competition coming up in Columbus, Ohio. But your structures aren't designed for that kind of weight bearing. We talked with Gracie V just a couple weeks ago, our Valentine's Day special for all you lovers out there. Hope you enjoyed it. But and her arm broke while she was bench pressing because the shirt, her arm gave before the shirt gave. You see? So structurally, yes, in the peripheral nervous system, it's like, you know what, I liken it to like a tree with branches. The trunk of the tree is your central nervous system, and all the branches that come out that filter all down into your toes and fingers, that's the peripheral nervous system. That's where you get your radiating nerve pain from a bulging disc. That's where you get your lateral epicondylitis or your ulnar nerve pain in your forearm and that kind of thing, carpal tunnel, whatever.
And if I can even abuse this even a little bit further. To a large degree, a high level of sports performance is, in fact, almost, it's probably not good wording, but almost a self-imposed nervous system downregulation. A lot of being able to hold 1,000 pounds over your torso is beating your nervous system down to the point where it no longer resists doing something that it wasn't designed to do.
Right. Well, I mean, there's a lot of overcoming an inherent fear. There's a risk involved. The fear of death, being crushed to death. I mean, there's a lot of those things that go into it, certainly. And I would say that another component of it, too, and again, I don't want to jump back on those poor performance-enhancing drugs, but a lot of folks, before they train real heavy, they get all jacked up on, you know, what are essentially non-regulated, amphetamines. And that's got to be taxing as well.
That's actually where I was going to go, is whoever originally started this schmoz that Donnie Thompson, brought to us, probably, and I'm speaking maybe a little out of turn, but I think I'm onto something because I do this for a living. I do this all fucking day long. Chances are the person that originally was speaking was not, in fact, suffering from nervous system downregulation or CNS stress or anything of that nature. Probably what this person was suffering from is exactly what you alluded to. What the Eastern Europeans, if you read any of the Eastern European tomes, if you read Vershansky or any of those guys, you will find in the margin reference to arousal fatigue. Arousal fatigue. Their term, not mine, although I do dig it. It's good.
By the way, it's since you're talking about arousal, it's la petite mort.
Ah, la petite mort.
See, that sounds way sexier than
the small death.
The little death.
That's not necessarily the little. That's la petite. It's tiny and feminine. The small feminine death. Yeah, la petite. Somewhere in the back of my mind, somewhere I learned some French. But anyway, arousal fatigue. And being one of the West Side peripherals, you might know that Louis Simmons often preaches against psyching up. I suspect maybe he doesn't know why, but I'm sure that he knows from observation that it's relevant. And the reason it is relevant is because arousal, the excitement, the emotional excitement of preparing for, quote, game day, for the big event, for the thing, is actually an endocrinological event. Your body is washed with hormones, with endocrine compounds, adrenaline, noradrenaline, glucagon, all these catecholamines. Those things that have amphetamine-like effects, or as you earlier alluded, when you take amphetamines and stimulate all of these things, you stimulate a false chemical arousal. Those endocrine systems break down very quickly.
Right.
They are very, very powerful. That fight or flight response is hugely powerful. But again, the way biology is designed, or the way biology come to be, is you better not be running for your life every minute of every day.
No,
you'll simply die.
Yeah, it's an overload.
Response is enormous.
Well,
right. The response is enormous, but it's intended to have large breaks in between.
Well, you're
and when people are doing this, every day, sometimes twice a day, they're causing them chemical distress that they're interpreting as the end result of nervous inadequacy, but it's really a chemical distress.
Right, arousal fatigue. And, because even before you get ready just to do a little bit of light exercise, if you're a runner, your heart rate actually speeds up. I mean, before you actually get started. Then it settles back down into its normal. But your body actually prepares to perform.
Oh, absolutely.
Your body prepares to perform.
As a matter of fact, if it hasn't become apparent to anyone who has listened to me for more than a moment, I'm a complete and total data file. I record everything. how many times I eat, what I eat, where I eat, who I eat it with, everything. I record everything. I record what time my workout is, what the temperature is, the humidity, yeah, everything. And one of the things I could tell you is I train Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 5 p.m. from 5 to 7. That's when I train, and Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 5 to 7. I do other things other days, but that's when I weight train. But here's the rub. If I measure my pulse at 5:15 on Tuesday, it's elevated.
Yeah. Because your body
Tuesday and Thursday, and Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, my pulse goes up at 5:15 because my body is fully expecting me to jump under a squat bar or a bench or whatever.
That's right. That's right.
That's how well tuned the body is. And most of what these people that are thinking they have CNS fatigue or some sort of peripheral nerve issue or whatever, most likely what they have is adrenal and associated hormonal fatigues from the wild over-emotionalization of their workouts and the stupefying addiction to these goddamn pre-workout fucking goofy-ass potions.
There you go.
Drink a cup of coffee, cinch up your fucking panties, and go to the gym. If you need to find your workout in a bottle, you're as bad as my fucking drunken father. You're not going to find it. Anyway, I'm sorry. I'm not fucking angry today.
All right, then. Well, yes, and that's all the time we have for today.
Chavez needs a pill now.
Good Lord, I think he needs a sedative. Certainly no more anabolics, because he'll become even more enraged and probably harm some children. Some children on his way to the grocery store to get some more amphetamines. But
right.
So I think that you should all relax, maybe have a cup of coffee. And just tighten up your belt.
Which is good for you. The government says so.
Pull up your super britches and go to work. But it's been a very exciting show. Again, I want to thank our guest, whoever it was. Now I want to thank our guest, our good friend, Danny Dague from Lexington Xtreme. He's going to put on one hell of a meet. I am going to talk to Gene Richlack, though. Because Gene Richlack is supposedly good friends, good bosom buddies, he's a good egg friends with old Al Thompson. So I'm going to get the scoop on that and see if that's in fact true.
He's got a silly-ass haircut. I mean, I could see them hanging out together.
Yeah, you know, you never know. Well, what happens in Pennsylvania, you know, hopefully stays in Pennsylvania. But this has been the RX Power Hour. We want to thank you all of you people that are jumping on board, all of you people that are supporting Strongman, hey, supporting powerlifting too, because we definitely love powerlifting, and all of the other strength sports that are listening to us. Thank you very much for doing so. We're going to keep it coming to you as long as we can, baby. You know, we're going to sleep with the enemy. We're going to fight the good fight, and to the bitter end, we're going to keep it going. But I do want to thank you all for participating, and we'll have some more questions of the week and give you more information on the Thompson saga, and we'll keep poking at Brian, because by God, it's the right thing to do. Chavez, you got anything you want to say?
I think I'm over it. I think I've got it all out of my system. Thanks to everybody. Support strength sports. Fuck Al Thompson and anybody else that wants to play those silly fucking games. You know, strength is great. Drugs, you know, it's part of it. It's unfortunate. It's real. But just deal with it. You know, teach your kids right. They'll be okay. We can still be strong. We'll get on with it.
Yeah, and for God's sakes, keep Al Thompson away from your kids. That's Jesus, all, and that's all the time we do have. Do want to thank all the folks over at RX Muscle for supporting us. I want to thank B.Chavez for being way smarter than anybody should be. Yikes! I didn't understand at least five words that he said, and you know my verbosity is absolutely legendary. But I want to thank the French for the term "la petite mort," because that's my new favorite term. And I want to thank
it really is, isn't it?
And I want to thank my good friend David Carradine too. Although I never met David Carradine, I did. I was a huge fan of David Carradine's, and it is unfortunate that the 13th death recorded because of masturbation was auto asphyxia, and it was David Carradine hanging in his closet naked somewhere in Thailand. But always an exciting. Always an exciting visual. When you can snatch the pebble from my hand, it will be time to leave. Thanks for Krista T for hanging in there with me. I want to thank my peeps, Little Michael, Sis, and G. You guys are always with me. I am Mikey J. Die, motherfucker. Die, motherfucker. Die.
Don't need your hate. I don't need your resentment.